So we're going to go over the walkthrough of the ABX-2L fin fan kit. And essentially it's an accessory, and over kind of right here is the actual fin fan kit itself. But to be able to utilize it, you either need an ABX-2L system, or you would need to purchase these components separately. You'd need the control box, an ABX-2L tractor, and the horizontal and vertical carriages. And we'd be glad to sell those to you if you don't already have those. But if you already have an ABX-2L, really all you need is a kit part over here. And the kit is made up of two clamp assemblies. Those will clamp on either side of the header box, a snout. This particular one is 7 foot, and it has guide tubes on the end as well as collets to catch the hose crimp. There's a guide assembly, and this will fit right into the current vertical positioner carriage. And then this is where your two guide tubes adjustments are made. We also have some optional items, which would include the top rail. If you're going to buy a continuous length, you want that to be about 30 inches longer than the fin fan exchanger you're cleaning. And a much shorter vertical rail. And that one you'll want about 18 inches longer than the depth of the fin fan header box. We can also supply, or you can purchase from some other location, but you'd probably want a slimline coupler, a nipple or stinger, and then a banshee tool. We're going to go ahead and install the fin fan kit. We'll be installing it just on a mock-up fin fan assembly here. But you'll want to start with the two clamp assemblies. And you'll want to notice that these do have a slot and another countersunk hole. These clamps can be moved to that position in order to get more standoff from the face of the fin fan. If you had some instrumentation tubes or some other obstructions you needed to move around. In order to do that, you just push in on this this tang on the end of the clamp. And then the bottom of the clamp just pulls off. You would unscrew this flathead screw, move the clamp to this position, and then relocate the screw over here. And as you're installing these, you just want to try to make sure that you're as square to the bundle as possible. I'll go ahead and install the second clamp. Kind of want to make sure they're squared up. And then we're ready to install the top rail. And if you were setting up on a real fin fan exchanger, you'd want to leave about 30 inches on this side so that the carriage has enough travel to hit these tubes on the end. Next, you'll install the horizontal carriage. And this is a standard carriage that's from the lightweight positioner. And these have a nice feature that you can just loosen the handle. It allows you to manually position the carriage where you want. And then you just engage the slotted rail and tighten it up. Next, you'll install the vertical rail. And this is the LWP vertical rail or carriage here. And it has a similar gearbox. You can loosen this handle and it allows you to manually position the carriage where you want it. One thing I did forget to mention is that you want the slots facing out. You know, if you do get those installed in some other orientation, you'll have to take it back loose and turn it so the slots are facing out. To install the snout to the ABX-2L tractor, you'll start with the end of the snout that just has a single attachment block, and it attaches with the same two pins that the guide attaches with. Now I'll go ahead and run the hoses through the snout and make sure I get my hoses all set up, and then we'll hook the snout up to the guide assembly on the fin fan unit. Okay, so once you have the snout attached to the tractor, you'll want to remove these pins and collets so the hoses are free to exit the outside of the tubes. I would recommend installing the tools on the end of the hoses to protect the threads, and it helps navigate the spring snout a lot easier. You can go ahead and install your collets again. You'll want to make sure you have the correct hose collets for the hose size and pressure you're using. The guide assembly, it just takes the place of the normal ABX-100 guide with the adjustable tube pitch. You can notice that this one is allowed to move, and that's how you set your pitch. And the pitch is variable from 1¾ inches to 4 inches. And it just slides into the same clamp location and gets tightened up. And this mock-up fin fan that we're setting up on has about a 10-inch gap for the header box. So we've selected 6-inch nipples or stingers and slimline couplings, and I'll go ahead and install those now. And we recommend always putting anti-seize on all your pipe or all your hose connection fittings. And the key to making sure you can get across that header box without having any issues is to have enough rigid length here that that you're able to span that area between where the plugs come out on the front of the header box and where the actual tube sheets start. And so with all your tools and everything on, it's always good to verify that you have the correct collets in. You should check the manual. But you can also just try to retract the hoses and make sure they both catch on the stops. And now we're ready to install the snout. These two guide tubes are set up for B18s, but these clamps will work for guide tubes for being 13s, being 15s, and being 18s. We usually set these up with a quarter to a half inch from the face of the fin fan. And I start by tightening this block on this side. It's a stationary block and doesn't affect the pitch. The second guide tube, as you can see, is you can adjust your pitch. At the minimum pitch, it's about 1¾ inches, and at the maximum pitch, it's 4 inches, and you can get it set anywhere in there that you would like. And then you can always loosen up the horizontal, and it allows you to rotate and kind of get directly lined up with the tube. And now everything would be ready to go. We're just gonna run it with air.